I would just like to make two points. Firstly, the member cast doubt on whether these lapses have compromised on the interests of residents. Madam Speaker, during the severe haze in 2013, a community hospital appealed to a GRO for air purifiers for patients in their non-aircon wards. The item was in great demand during this haze period and was out of stock across all major retail outlets in Singapore. The grassroots leaders, the volunteers, they went all around Singapore. Finally, they found a store. A small store has a limited stock. They quickly purchased their air purifiers without asking for three quotes, as they were in a hurry, in a great hurry, to purchase these air purifiers to help to alleviate the discomfort of the patients. Madam Speaker, is this a case of non-compliance of financial procedure and rules? Answer is yes. Is this a case of grassroots leaders, volunteers, compromising on the interests of the community? The answer is certainly no. In another instance, a CC awarded one tenancy, a contract, to a non-profit community organization without competition. This was to promote healthy lifestyle. In particular, counting on this organization to reach out to the senior residents with an annual outreach of 20,000 residents to help them to stay healthy. The CC, they did not seek the prior approval of the PHQ. So it was certainly a case of non-compliance of financial rules. Again, is this a case of compromising the interests of residents? As far as I'm concerned, as Deputy Chairman of PA, answer is no. Madam Speaker, I want to assert this point that far from compromising on the interests of the residents, as a member has asserted, the GROs that committed these lapses were actually doing their best to serve the interests of the residents and meet the urgent needs of the community. We can fault them for their non-compliance of financial procedures, but please do not doubt them in their passion and commitment in always doing the best for the community. My second point is that I wish to clarify with the member that the PA and the GROs, their accounts are subjected to annual audits, to internal audits every year. Yes, been so. Will continue to be the case. What happened was there was a change in the statutory board financial reporting standards. With that revision, PA was required to include the GRO's accounts into our financial statements. So please bear in mind, there was a change in the statutory board financing reporting standard. We have 1,800 GRO's accounts. It's a big number. So the PA, we took 4 years, account by account, it took us 4 years to consolidate these 1,800 GRO accounts into the PA financial statements. The completion, the consolidation was completed by FY 2013. And for that year, the first year of consolidation, our financial statement received a clean audit opinions. For that year, 2013, first year of our consolidated account, and likewise, FY 2014. So in other words, the moment the accounts were consolidated, 1,800 of them, in fact, the PA, together with GRO account, financial statement, was certified by external auditors to be of clean audit opinions, meaning that the financial statement is reliable, the accounting system is sound. Hence, contrary to the misperception of the member, I want to state it clearly that the financial statements and accounting system of PA and the GROs are in order as certified by the external auditor for FY 2013 and FY 14, since we've completed the consolidation of GRO accounts into PA financial statement. This means that public funds are properly spent and accounted for. Even though many of these incidents arose out of good intention of the GROs in serving the community, they are nonetheless non-compliance of the financial rules. So the findings of the AGO audits point to two key areas of weaknesses. First, the GRO might not be familiar with the financial regulations. And secondly, there's weak supervision of the GROs in complying with financial regulation. These are areas of weakness which we have taken immediate steps to improve. In fact, we also set up a grassroots finance review committee led by individuals with good standing in the financial and accounting community. The member asked whether this review committee would be impartial in their review. Madam, let me highlight the key profile of these three members. The review committee is chaired by Mr. Timothy D'Souza. He's a trustee of the European Association of Singapore. The two key members are Mr. John Teo Woon King. He is by profession a chief financial officer, at the same time a member of the Auditing and Assurance Standards Committee of the Institute of Singapore Chartered Accountants. Lastly, Mr. Chiang Heng Liang, he's a director of wealth management in the International Bank. Yeah, so in other words, these three persons, they do have the standing in the community and the expertise to guide us in this review. On top of that, we also have access to advisors, resource person from the Ministry of Finance. In conclusion, I want to assure this House that notwithstanding these procedural lapses, no doubt we have made mistakes and we have accepted the responsibility many times, including today, twice in this House. There's no question about that. Yeah. However, I think it's important also to point out that the financial statement and accounting system of the PA and the GROs are accurate and reliable. Yeah. The House is not on fire. The House is not at the risk of collapsing. We've learned from the findings of the AGO and will improve to do better.